The Dell Pro Max Tower T2 desktop has a tough act to follow. Not only is it one of the first systems released under Dell's new Pro Max brand, but it replaces the most popular model from Dell's nearly 30-year-old Precision brand. Going forward, Dell will have just three main brands: Dell for home or consumer use, Dell Pro for regular office PCs, and at the top of the range, the Dell Pro Max, offering the highest performance and support for professional applications such as SOLIDWORKS and CATIA. The 2024 Dell Precision 3680 was our recommended system from Dell's previous Precision range for CAT, and it's succeeded by this new Dell Pro Max Tower T2 desktop. Sounds simple enough, but you may wonder, what does the T2 mean, especially as there isn't a T1 or indeed a T3 or above currently. The word we have from Dell is they expect to utilize other numbers in future once more of the previous generation Dell Precision Towers are replaced. However, it's likely this model will remain our go-to system for most CAD users. With that out of the way, what about the system itself? Well, the chassis has grown slightly in all directions, now a 32-litre chassis rather than a 27-litre chassis in the previous generation, to accommodate even more powerful components, retaining the large hexagonal mesh at the front for plenty of airflow. There are also plenty of ports with two USB-A and two USB-C and audio connectors at the front, as well as options for an optical drive and a lockable storage bay at the top of the system. And at the rear, we have four more USB-A ports, one Thunderbolt 4, one regular USB-C, plus one gigabit wired network, with an extra space available to add an optional 5 gigabit network, additional USB-C, or display connectors. And while there are two DisplayPort connectors at the top of the system, these go via the onboard Intel graphics. We always advise connecting your monitors to the dedicated graphics card at the bottom of the system to ensure top performance. Next, onto the internals. The main change at launch is the new Dell Pro Max range feature the Intel's latest Ultra 200 series CPUs. The 100 series never made it to desktops, so this is the first time we're seeing another new brand name in high performance desktops. Gone is the familiar with Intel's Core i5, i7 and i9, first released in 2008, now being replaced with the new Ultra 5, 7 and 9 naming convention. These CPUs are more efficient than previous generations when running day-to-day tasks, and part of this is the dedicated neural processing unit, or NPU, for accelerating AI tasks locally. This is already being leveraged today for tasks such as blurring your background on a video call, which, as well as being more efficient, leaves your CPU and graphics card free for more intensive tasks. This can be paired with up to 128GB of workstation grade error correction code RAM for increased stability, particularly beneficial for long running critical tasks such as simulations. On the graphics side, there is no change for now, with the T2 still having support for the entire NVIDIA Ada generation professional graphics stack, up to the 48GB NVIDIA RTX 6000 Ada generation. But watch out for an update from us later this summer as NVIDIA's new RTX PRO Blackwell range launches. Initially, this will be higher end cards, with the first to launch being the 96GB RTX PRO 6000 Blackwell Workstation Edition, running at 600 watts. While this is well beyond what most would need for CAD, it is ideal for GPU accelerated workloads like visualization, high end simulation, and AI. Following these will be the 24GB RTX PRO 4000, the 32GB RTX PRO 4500, and the 48GB RTX PRO 5000 Blackwell cards, with the 4000 series cards being more suited to most engineering workflows and budgets. Meanwhile, Dell R&D have focused on ensuring these systems perform at their maximum and have developed an air shroud to channel air from the intake fan at the top of the system across the large air cooler before being exhausted out at the rear of the system. This means the CPU can run at the top of Intel's spec in what Dell refer to as unlimited turbo mode, maximizing performance and allowing the processor to run at up to 250 watts without any throttling due to heat. Systems with the most powerful K-series CPU automatically get this feature along with the 1500 watt power supply. The separation from the graphics card also will allow support for the ever more powerful graphics cards without all of that heat recirculating within the system. The graphics card has its own intake fan at the front to ensure a supply of cool air to the graphics card's own cooling system. So how does it perform? We know many will be looking to upgrade this year, with the end of support for Windows 10 in October 2025, and software from the likes of SOLIDWORKS and Dassault Systems ending support at the same time. Newer versions of the software will no longer install on Windows 10. So we compared the Dell Pro Max Tower T2 desktop against the oldest workstation that supports Windows 11, and the Dell Precision 3630 from 2018, and also the Dell Precision 3650 from summer 2021, right in the middle of our recommended 3 to 5 year replacement cycle. So if you're thinking about upgrading, should you just upgrade your existing system to Windows 11? Or is it time for a full upgrade? For part modeling, the new Pro Max Tower took around half the time of our 2018 system, down from 49 seconds on the 2018 system to 25 seconds on the new Pro Max, and still a healthy improvement versus the Precision 3650 from 2021, which was 40 seconds to generate the same features. And for assemblies, the story is similar, with our large assembly taking just 50 seconds to open on the Dell Pro Max. This is less than half the 1 minute and 45 seconds taken on the 2018 workstation, and around 20 seconds quicker than our 2021 system. These speedups are relatively consistent across a variety of tasks and add up significantly across the working week. Performance improvements in our static simulation test were up around 35% versus the 2018 system and 25% versus the 2021 workstation. And finally, the new Pro Max Tower T2 was particularly strong for SOLIDWORKS flow simulation, completing our test simulation in just 28 minutes. That's 3 times faster than the 2018 system and around 2.5 times faster than that from 2021. This is most likely due to the improvements Intel have made to their efficiency cores in the latest Ultra 200 series CPUs, as while we saw similar single-threaded performance to the previous generation CPUs, the multi-threaded performance increased significantly, bringing performance into line with the considerably more expensive 2024 Dell Precision 7875 system featuring an AMD Threadripper CPU with 32 cores. In our tests, high-end simulations such as Simulia Abacus is the main exception that can leverage CPUs with many more cores and massive memory quantities available on this platform. Ultimately, when choosing a system, bigger is not always better. You can spend many multiples of our recommended system and get no improvement or indeed worse performance, so please get in touch if you're unsure on the right configuration for you. And if you're thinking about replacing your current system, this doesn't mean that the old system is useless, just that CAD users are amongst those whose productivity benefits most from upgrading hardware regularly. You may be able to repurpose it inside your company to users with less demanding workflows, or take advantage of Dell's asset recovery program to ensure it is repurposed or recycled securely and responsibly, plus you get a bit of cash back in return. To sum up, the Dell Pro Max Tower T2 is a worthy successor to the Dell Precision name, building on the strong foundations of last year's model with even more capacity for high performance components, and it remains our go-to system from Dell's range for the majority of designers and engineers.